Natalia's work represents a new approach to medicine, using quantitative analysis and modeling to enhance diagnosis and treatment.
In my research, we generate virtual twins of the patient's hearts. These are digital replicas that are generated using the patient's MRI or other scans. We take the scans, and the scans reflect not only the geometry of the heart, but also any other structural change that underlies the disease in this heart.
Computer simulations have rarely been used in medicine. In medicine, we have a different approach. It's called trial and error. In my lab, and my collaborators want to change that. We want to bring computer simulation to the clinical practice.
This way, we can elicit responses that can tell us what is wrong with this heart. So when the patient has the procedure in the clinic, the doctors can directly execute the plan that we proposed that fits this patient best.
I've found that her lab is unique in that we're able to really bring what we do in the lab directly to the bedside. And I think that is really gratifying. I've had multiple bioethics discussions with my lab mates, and because we realize just how important the work we're doing is, and also just how much of a profound impact it can have on patient lives. And I think that kind of mix of the science as well as the clinical aspects really is what makes our lab truly unique.
We are very excited about bringing our technology of virtual hearts in the clinic, and we recently got approval by the FDA for two clinical studies. This is very exciting because it's the first time that the FDA has approved a study in which the treatment of patient is driven by computer simulations.
One thing that I've learned from Natalia that's definitely going to have a lasting impact on my career is how to get things done. When she has an idea, whether it's bringing her virtual heart models to the clinic or forming the new advanced center, she does it. She doesn't take no for an answer. And I think I've become like a lot more confident in doing that on my own.
I had in my lab a wall of shame in which we will put all the rejections. This is a great mentor. Rejection is a great mentor because you learn how to move forward despite the gut punch that you receive when you have a rejection. And it's particularly important for girls. You have to stand up and move, and you have to believe in what you're doing, because one day you will show the world that you were right.